It is a joy and a privilege to welcome you to worship this Sunday before Christmas. I find it such a privilege because I've already seen the wondrous music that the people of this church are bringing to you today. And believe me when I say, this is a worship service that will fill your heart with song. And now let us pray. Gracious God, it is said that music is the sound of angels. And we give you thanks for the music, for the words, for the opportunity to join together, worshiping you, worshiping with the wonderful music that ultimately comes from you and this day returns to your heavens. For your love, for your peace, for your joy, we give you thanks and praise. Amen. And now, please join in the call to worship. We have spoken words of hope.
All our hope is in the Lord.
We have spoken words of peace.
In Christ, we are blessed with the peace that passes all understanding.
We have spoken words of joy.
For joy in the Lord is our strength.
Today, we are speaking words of love. Hear these words from Psalm 89. I will sing of the Lord's great love forever. With my mouth, I will make your faithfulness known through all generations. I will declare that your love stands firm forever, that you have established your faithfulness in heaven itself. You said, I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant, I will establish your line forever and make your throne firm through all generations. In our songs and our music, we worship the Lord.
Thy rise and throne. no crib for a bed. The little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he lay. And little boy Jesus asleep on the hay.
So you know what we gotta do? We gotta go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that a Jesus Christ is born. A wild shepherds watch their keeping, war silent flocks by night. Behold, throughout the heavens, there shone a holy light. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that a Jesus Christ is born. A wild shepherd's feet and tremble, oh Lord, across the earth. The angels sing in chorus and hail the Savior's birth. One more time, we gotta go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that a Jesus Christ is born, that a Jesus Christ is born.
And who is this Christ child? There are many carols and many hymns, and in our confessions of faith, we strive to explain and understand. Hear now these words from the Confession of 1967. God reveals divine love in Jesus Christ by showing power in the form of a servant, wisdom in the folly of the cross, and goodness in receiving sinful men and women. The power of God's love in Christ to transform the world discloses that the Redeemer is the Lord and Creator who made all things to serve the purpose of God's love.
It is Lord of all. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will lead, the dumb will speak, the praises of the baby boy. was heaven's perfect lamb. The sleeping child you're holding is the great, the great I am. Mary, yes, I think you
We celebrate a birth that happened so long ago with angels near the earth and harps of gold. We continue to celebrate because it is an ongoing reality. That child born so long ago continues to live in our own lives, in our own hearts. We affirm the words that begin the brief statement of faith. In life and death, we belong to God. Through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, we trust the one triune God, the Holy One of Israel, whom alone we worship and serve. Let us pray. Loving God, during this Christmas season of 2020, we come before you with hearts anxious and yet believing, holding on to the music, to the stories that tell of your love, knowing how much we still need a Savior. And we pray for one another, not because we believe that we have any special power, but because we trust in you. And in that trust, we lift up Harlene Blair's husband, Ken, who's in a memory care facility and tested positive for COVID. We pray for others who have tested positive for COVID, who've gotten sick, some who are better, some who are not. And we pray for their families and loved ones, that you will sustain them through it all. We pray for Ashley, who now has internal bleeding, and no one is sure why. We ask your loving support and your healing action. We pray for Aaron Peterson, that firefighter who is still struggling to regain sight in one eye, damaged by a burning ember. Be with him and his family as he awaits an appointment in January with specialists. We pray for Bill receiving chemo, tolerating the chemicals that are keeping his cancer from spreading. And as we think of all of these issues our loved ones have with their health, we pray for our healthcare workers, that you will strengthen them and sustain them. Help them day by day to have strong bodies and clear minds, open hearts, as they seek to minister to those in need. And we pray for one another in the church, that wherever we are in our own lives, we will be faithful. We will see you at work in our lives, and continue to know that you are standing with us day by day. In that confidence, please join me in the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now go out into the world in peace. Let your hearts be lifted up by the music you have heard. Take that love of God. Feel it for yourself. Share it with one another. And the peace and the love and the strength of our Lord Jesus Christ will be with you today and every day.